If you need extra hands, I think someone's got a career as a waiter.
Adding to the Constructicon team and carrying a name used from a few completely different alliterations, the question is, who is Overload? Well, seemingly a nobody that was mostly seen in concept, but only the truck appeared to combine with Devastator. However, with only a Legends mold before it, he got the opportunity to make a physical appearance in toy form in Studio Series, as the combiner seems to need it. This was sent thanks to TFA1024 on YouTube. His alt mode resembles the Caterpillar Articulated Dump Truck, a massive hauling machine that could potentially take the bigger or longer loads compared to long haul. Although you could probably tell, this is certainly lackluster. They certainly had to take a lot of focus on the hip form. This needs to be a strong pair of pants for a beefy mess of a monster, so there's a ton of shortcomings. Exposed joints and kibble isn't new with the Constructicons, Rampage is a big example, but Overload's just not feeling it. It's especially apparent on the back, the uneven shovel that has to adjust for the different legs, and the silver greebling isn't even trying. Couldn't get the budget for a panel? There's also a bonus mixing drum piece with green details that can store on top for storage, I guess? How does this build make sense and no sense? There's a lot of strong joints that accordion straightforward, and it's a little tricky to align properly. But even if all the wheels don't hit the ground, it rolls pretty well. The legs don't really incorporate much to the assembly, so there's more focus on converting to the vehicle shape. You could spot some surprisingly appropriate textures with a one-sided canopy, blue windows, and a good-looking front with lights, a grille, ladders, and we can ignore the spiky bits. I think I can safely say we didn't expect perfection. I can't even store all my mini peanut butter cups in here. It's not necessarily good. So why do I love it so much? I think it's just so stupidly simple, but it's just a big long red truck and I love just driving this thing around. Not only that, if everything's correct, it's a pretty solid thick brick. I know one costs $70 Canadian, but I could build either Devastator or a house against the big bad wolf. Also, with the peg hole originally made to store Rampage's stand, you can add a weapon. Although the details are surprising, the cracks leave a lot to be desired. Still, I'm surprised that I can enjoy this. I can tell this wasn't the engineered focus, but for what it's worth, I like it. Robot mode. This guy's pretty subtle. I mean, he's just your typical movie design Decepticon with extra limbs and something of a scorpion tail. You know, a lot of the Constructicons are very unique, yet come together respectively, not just in vehicle form. Overload has had a few altered concepts, notably with four legs instead, but I don't know if you noticed the four arms. That's fair, an extra pair of hands could be useful, especially in construction. That is, until you realize he has claws and meat hooks instead of hands. Interesting fact, he's not much taller than Rampage or Longhaul, which resulted in early releases with a reduced Voyager price tag. But when you see how wide he is, he's certainly fitting of a leader. I mean, have you ever considered playing football professionally? From the setup, the tailpiece looks more like a back spike and the wheels just tuck away, but besides that, he looks pretty respectable for something that also converts into an integral combiner piece. Honestly, the weakest part is the legs, and they don't even do much for the torso. The hips are an issue, the knees are too weak, but the kneecaps help, and I appreciate the foot tilt, but as soon as you do it, the leg is so thin. I do like the fake wheel detail. Actually, overall, the detail is good, especially when it's painted in silver. There's also headlights painted. The head sculpt is interesting. The movies will sometimes recycle entire models or components of others. So did you not think I wouldn't be able to spot Longhaul's mouth? He also has a cyclops eye. It's looking like a Bayverse version of Earthrise Airwave. Alright, so quick update, there are actual yellow eyes. Did someone say? Articulation! Ball-jointed head, shoulders up and down, forward and back, up and down, tight rotation, forward to back, double elbow, claw, out and in, elbow, rotation below, double claw, hips out and in, forward and back, rotation below, knee bend, and foot tilt. Poseability is a surprise with the amount of joints, but there are some issues. The head is way too tight, you might pop it out of the chest before anything. The hips are really tight moving forward, I feel like they'll stress and break. The rotation in the hips is sloppy with the kibble, and as mentioned, the knees aren't the best. This rotation joint in the shoulder is so damn tight. What is majorly impressive is the arms. A few joints here and there feel missing, but with the construction of the combiner, there's still a ton going on for some very dynamic looks, including lobster attack, crab claw, and General Kenobi. No accessories as far as weapons. I mean, he's got hook hands and jaws of life I wish had an opening joint. Instead, the drum can attach to the back. Just what we need, more kibble. Now, I'm confused if this insect has a tail or thorax. Is this a Beast Wars Fusor? Wait, thorax, six limbs, insect face crotch. Is this a spider? While it's not really meant to hold weapons, I believe you can try and use the pegs on the claws. There's also a peg hole on this upper arm. Decent shoulder movement, by the way. What's Hot Rod's excuse? Overload is one of the more reliant figures in the combination, and I think they did a pretty good job. Sure, the legs just stay there, the head is clearly there. You can even rotate if you still want a combiner but only have the lower part. There's a rail system to connect the top, and the legs connect below. The hip joints are incredibly solid, but don't feel in this conversion that they're going to break. Not too loose, not too tight. I dig how the arms alter to give it a different shape, and look! We now have a spot for scrap metals. Whatever this is. I'm actually pretty surprised. The alt mode leaves more to be desired, and I don't think it would be vastly improved without the combination in the way. The legs are awkward, and some of the joints feel they could break, but as long as they stay, I'm impressed. Like I said, leaving a lot to be desired while still actually being actively fun. I like how solid the alt mode can be with its size, and the forearms are enjoyable. I was expecting issues, but for what it's worth, I'll go on a limb and say, I did not expect this to be a Constructicon highlight, and yet it is. Thanks to TFA1024 for sending this. Certainly wasn't in a rush from concept to toy.